What's up, YouTubers? So before we get started with this video, on First Take, they're going to be talking about how LaMelo Ball was the third overall pick in this year's draft to the Charlotte Hornets. So let's see what they have to say about that.
Go ahead. Go ahead, Max.
I would say LaMelo Ball, LaMelo is the guy with the highest upside in the draft. So I guess.
I agree.
Like, if you're going to draft in the top three, don't just get a nice piece. If you're Michael Jordan, you need a franchise player. At least roll the dice on someone who might be a franchise player. And LaMelo fits that description in terms of his passing ability and playmaking ability and size at the position, and maybe potential eventually to play defense, we'll see. But as I said, it looks like a broken shot, and there are a lot of question marks for a top three pick, although I suppose...
He's still young. That shot could be worked on and taken care of.
There are a lot of question marks throughout the draft. I want to say this about LaVar Ball, Stephen A., because you brought him up. One thing you could say about LaVar Ball, like, what are the question marks about his kids? Their shot, right? Is their form is funky, and is it repeatable? And do they have to tear it down and bring and build it back up? They're not A-plus athletes in terms of their explosiveness like some other dudes. Like, we bring up De'Aaron Fox in that Lonzo draft, not just because he gave it to him in college, you know, in the tournament, but because De'Aaron Fox was more explosive. So those are things that you could rightly criticize LaVar about. But what about playing the game the right way? Like, Lonzo Ball is one of those dudes who could not care less about his stats, who does what the team needs him to do. He might not have the ability to run faster than some of the other guys or to hit the shot, but he's looking to hook up his teammates and be part of a winning team. He has that mentality.
So Lonzo might be a team player to a fault, if that makes any sense, because he's so worried about dishing the ball to everybody else that he's not aggressive enough and he doesn't take the shot himself when he needs to be taking a shot some of the time. So I think he might be too much of a teammate to a fault, if that makes any sense.
And if you assume that LaMelo has the same mentality, that could be very good for a franchise, whether or not he ever becomes a superstar.
So LaMelo Ball was definitely way more aggressive than Alonzo. You can see that in high school. He was way more aggressive. I think, you know, LaMelo, he's only 19. Like I said, he's going to be 19 once the season starts next month with December 22nd. So he's still very young. He'll have plenty of time to work on his shot, and I think he'll be just fine. And maybe he can work on his defense too. I think he needs to work on. But, you know, having been 6'7 point guard, he's definitely, with his long arms, he's definitely going to be okay on defense once he works on that. And as far as LaVar Ball, I think LaVar Ball deserves a lot more credit than he's been given. So, you know, all the people were hating on him. So you need to let your boys live their life, you know, stop being so controlling and all that. What have your kids done lately? Because LaVar Ball had three boys go to UCLA or sign on to go to UCLA. So Lonzo, the first boy, he went to UCLA, did 1 year, and was out, drafted top three. Then the next year, you had LiAngelo. LiAngelo went to UCLA, but messed up, got caught in some type of trouble overseas in China and was suspended. They didn't say that he was expelled. He just said he was suspended. So he probably could have still been balling at UCLA right now if he wanted to. And then you have LaMelo Ball, the youngest boy. He was said he was committed to go to UCLA, but the relationship was ruined between UCLA and a Ball family because LiAngelo still in sunglasses in China. So LaVar Ball was decided, no, let me take LaMelo. We're going to go overseas and go pro. We don't need to go through college to get to the league. And sure enough, LaMelo Ball, the third overall pick in this year's draft to the Charlotte Hornets. You know, what have your kids done lately that you can criticize LaVar Ball? LaVar Ball deserves so much credit what he's done. His boys aren't getting DUIs. His boys aren't beating up their girlfriends. His boys aren't smoking weed. His boys aren't doing anything, even though LiAngelo messed up, which was a stupid mistake. But, you know, what have your kids done lately that you can even remotely compare to being what LaVar Ball did for his boys and what type of dad he is? Some people would kill to have a dad like LaVar Ball to do all the things they did. And like I said, he was absolutely right with what he said. Two of his boys out of three are going to make it, and they made it huge, top three. And one quick other thing. So his first son was drafted by Magic Johnson to the LA Lakers, and then his other boy was drafted by Michael Jordan, the GOAT, to the Charlotte Hornets. Yeah. What have your kids done lately?
Max, here's where I disagree with you about that, and I'm glad you brought that up with Jay here on the segment with us, because I'm going to disagree. I'm not saying you're wrong, but I'm just saying I don't have the same opinion that you have on this particular issue. I think in this day and age, please don't get me wrong, Jay, I'm not saying it's not important to play the right way. One of the people I love dearly is Larry Brown. I would never say something so sacrilegious. He'd have a heart attack if I said it wasn't important to play the right way. You know, that was his favorite sentence. But here's the deal. In today's day and age, particularly from the point guard spot, Max, I think it's important to care about your numbers. I think it's important to care about stats because I think it lends itself towards you displaying a level of aggression that will make you formidable because of the way the game has changed. When you can lollygag the ball up the court, throw it inside to a big man, and let him do his thing, that's different. But because today's style of NBA play is so predicated on guard play, you've got to be aggressive to be effective. If you are not aggressive, then you're not a threat. And if you're not a threat, then you don't impact the game the way they've manufactured it for you to impact the game. That's where I'm coming from, Jay. What do you say to that?
Nah, he's not talking about LaMelo, because LaMelo is definitely aggressive. He has no problem with being aggressive, and he also has no problem taking a shot. So I would not apply the same type of situation to, Lonzo. You know, LaMelo is definitely good as far as that. There's other things I'd rather have him work on, like his defense, because everybody likes to score, but he does need to play defense. But he has the whole build set up to play good defense against his position. But definitely, LaMelo Ball does not have any problem with being aggressive. He has no problem passing a rock. So I don't think that's any type of – that part of a game I wouldn't be worried about for his game.
I think LaMelo Ball is a different cat, Stephen A. Like, I think he does, at the end of the day, care about his stats. He also cares about winning. But the ball is going to be in his hands where he's going to make stuff happen. And his best attribute –
yeah, that's what I'm saying –
is that he's dynamic in screen and roll. He's dynamic in screen and roll. Right. You know that, Stephen A?
Yeah, good.
You can be the best defender in the world. If I put you in a PNR, doesn't matter. Doesn't matter how good of a defender you